Hi, we are now with Joseph Velasco, Artistic Director of City at Peace. How are you doing?
I'm doing great, thanks.
It's good to be here with you today. And I would like to start this interview by asking you, what is City at Peace?
City at Peace is a nonprofit organization and it's designed to help young people to perform an arts program but also does conflict resolution. And so we get a wide variety of kids that get together and talk about issues affecting their lives. And from those life stories that we end up hearing about and working through, we ended up working on an original play that they ended up producing in the spring. And we've had a lot of students return because they love the process and we're just about to get started on a new season.
When was it first founded?
City at Peace is a national program and there's different programs in Los Angeles, Baton Rouge, Charlotte. The very first year was in Washington, D.C., started by Paul Griffin. And my partner, Nancy Davis, heard about the program and there was a lot of stuff going on with gang violence at that time in the early 90s. And she really wanted to do something. So she got a hold of Paul Griffin, and Santa Barbara then became the second city to have a City at Peace program.
Great. Now, why do you choose performing arts as the main creative process?
Well, performing arts allows students or young people who never would think about auditioning for a play, maybe they never thought about it, never thought they had musical talent or could dance or act or write. And what we do is we don't normally look for the drama kids, the kids that are already doing it. We look for kids that have a story to tell, have something that they want to work through, some sort of issue. And so we don't audition, and we're a very different program for that. And the second thing is, the program is completely free. So with those two things, we really try to get a wide cross-section of students from all over, and the age range is from 13 to 19. And we put them all together and talk about what's going on in your life, what's really going on as a teenager. And from those life stories, we end up building a script, and that script ends up being a really true-to-life account of what's going on for young people today.
Good. So how many students are per year, more or less?
Well, we usually have 30 to 35 students that go through our doors. By the time, for various reasons, students drop out, maybe they're working or maybe they're struggling in school, but we end up having 20 to 25 students that are in the show every year, and the show's usually done at Center Stage Theater.
Now, you were already mentioned some aspects of the production process with the script. So they do write their own play?
Yeah, they write their own lyrics to the songs. They write their own scripts. It's not so much that we're a drama program, but that we're really allowing kids to tell their stories. And theater's a medium where we use music and we use dancing, we use movement and mask work and all kinds of other things to help them tell those stories. But that at the heart of it is, what is your life story and how is that universal? I tell my adult facilitators they are not allowed to write dialogue. Only the students can write dialogue, the young people that are in the program, because as adults, we're no longer teenagers. And if we write dialogue, it's gonna sound false or sound phony. So the students really, once they realize that we're really serious about them writing the dialogue, they really own it and they work in small groups. Sometimes they'll write monologues. And we have a wonderful playwright in residence, Sojourner Kincaid Roll, who's a local poet, who helps the students find that voice. But I'm really happy that every year the script is entirely written by the students.
Excellent. Now, I understand that at some rehearsals, you have guest artists coming to talk about violence prevention and other important topics. Could you tell me more about those sessions?
Well, we look at a lot of the issues that are going on with young people, whether it's suicide, whether it's drugs, whether we talk about everything. And one of the things that we really like about our program that we're very proud of is that it's confidential. That when the young people come and we sit in the circle and we do a check-in, that what is said in the circle is going to stay in the circle. And so a lot of issues then come up because they realize it's a safe place for them to come and share those thoughts and ideas that they might have. And if somebody's having a hard time, they know that there's a place for support. I've already had over the summer, because we don't usually do City at Peace over the summer, some of our past young people saying, when are we going to start up again? Because they want that place to come to be able to share and feel supported.
Good, almost like therapy.
Yes, a little bit.
Now, which other skills they get through the program?
Well, we have the writing, obviously. We have wonderful guest artists. John Douglas, he's our musical director, works with a lot of different groups in town, helps write the music with the students. They usually will write a poem, and then he'll take it and begin to craft a song and then work with them to find what's their range. He also teaches them how to sing. These are young people who maybe have never sung before, and he gets them, I don't know how he does it, but they always sound amazing. Matt Tavanini does movement. He's one of the members of Boxtails, and he's been really helping working with young people. So we've had a number of guest artists come, and I think when young people realize that no matter what, on any given Wednesday, because we're always Wednesday from 4 to 8, that there's going to be this group of people that are there to support them and care for them. That's why they keep coming back.
Good. So tell me, at the end of the show, they evaluate their experience with CDMPs, mm-hmm. right? So what do you hope they take with them for the future?
First and foremost is self-esteem. You know, you get kids that have been told that they're not good enough, and through our process, that they have a voice, that they do have something of value to share, even if it's something painful or something wonderful, that all of that thrown in the mix is important. And what we're trying to say is, whoever you are, your story is valuable, and you need to share it and have a voice, and here's a vehicle in which to do that. That's a safe place to explore those issues, whatever comes up for you.
Great. So how can people get involved?
They could go to the national website, and our information's there, or they can call our office at 899-4292, leave a message. We're going to be starting every fall at the Libero Theater, which is graciously this year has allowed us to use their space as a rehearsal. And students can drop in at any time. Like I said, we don't audition. If they come and find it's for them, we have a very open door policy. So we've had young people join in the middle of the season. We've had young people join at the beginning of the season. Our feeling is, if you're willing to come and spend the time with us, then we want to hear your story.
Well, thank you, Joseph, for all that information. If you donate money to this organization, you help two things, arts and youth, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, thanks for being with us today, and best for you and CDMPs.
All right, thank you so much.
For more information on the Nonprofit Spotlight, check our website at www.sbchannels.tv.